Good morning, kids. Good morning, families. Welcome to Crossroads Key Biscayne Sunday School. There's Tanya. I'm Silver. It's a bittersweet day for us because, as some of you may know, we are saying goodbye to an amazing children director, Miss Tanya. She has been with us for the last year plus, and she has blessed all of our hearts, all of our lives. She's been amazing with our kids. We will definitely be missing her, and we wanted to take the opportunity to say goodbye to her and to tell her how much we appreciate her. But before we, you know, send her off with a prayer, we wanted to have her share a little bit with, you know, what she's gonna be doing next. So Tanya, what is going on? What's next for you?
So it's nothing too sudden. I was hoping the last 4 weeks to be with all of you so I could talk to you every week and, you know, catch up and let you know that it's been on my heart for a while to go on an adventure. My oldest daughter's in college and my youngest will be starting in August. So I will be an empty nester. And I thought I will travel around the country and visit friends and family for a while and then hopefully pursue my career in the airlines, being a flight attendant, which I don't know what God has planned now with airlines the way they are, but I'm excited to see what his plan is going to be for me, but I'm gonna miss all of you so much. It's just been such a thrill to be a part of your lives and be able to share the love of Jesus with you and the stories and the excitement every week, and also the volunteers and what a big part of my, a part of this adventure in life has been with the, all the volunteers who have helped and been there at the last minute and whenever I needed you. Thank you so much. You made this possible.
Yeah, I mean, it's been our pleasure having you, and we definitely have seen how God has used you with our kids, with our volunteers. So we're so grateful for your life and for your heart. And we know that God is going to use you in this next season.
Thank you. And I wanted to say thank you so much for a card that Silver gave me in honor of all of you. And what he wrote, this Bible verse really means a lot to me. And I feel like it was God talking to me yesterday when I needed it. Psalm 91:11. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. So thank you. I'm so sad to be leaving. I will be with you in heart and hopefully be back to visit.
Well, it's been our pleasure having you, and we're grateful. I just want to pray for you and start our Sunday school. So let's pray. Father God, we're so grateful for Miss Tanya. We're grateful for her heart and her life and the love that she has shown us, the lessons, the dedication that she has given to this ministry and to our kids and to our families. We just pray that you would guide her next steps, that you will be with her, that you would give her strength, that you will provide all her needs as she enters into this new season. I pray that wherever she goes, that you will shine your love through her life, and that others might be blessed by her and her testimony as we were blessed here at KB. Be with her, be with her family, protect them, and take care of her. We know that she's your daughter and that you love her and that you have great plans for her. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Thanks so much, Tanya. We're gonna start our Sunday school. Tanya, who's helping us? We got our guests, I guess, today?
So I am very excited that our Sunday school class will now be joining Pinecrest's Sunday school class with Miss Sally. And they are studying the Old Testament, which we started last week. So I'm very happy to pass all of you over. I hope you enjoy every week with her. And Miss Sally, take it away.
Hello, Key Biscayne Bridge kids. I'm Sally DeRue, and I am the Children's Director at the Crossbridge Pinecrest campus. You're going to be seeing more of me as I will be introducing you to the new kids' lessons on Sunday mornings. We will do some welcome games together, we'll do songs, we'll do scripture memory and praying together, and we'll learn a lot about the Bible. I can't wait to get to know you better, and I hope you enjoy it.
Good morning, Bridge Kids!
Hi, we're excited to see you again this morning, and today we're gonna do a scavenger hunt, okay? So I've got some clues that I'm gonna read to Katrina and Madeline, and they have to listen to know what to do, okay? You guys ready? Clue number one, you have two hands and two feet. You'll find the first clue under somebody's seat. Go find it, where do you think it is? Oh good, mommy's seat, that's right. Did you find it? Okay, so the next clue says, looking for your next direction, go to a place where you see your reflection.
Mirror.
So good job, do you see it?
Has to be okay.
It is.
Oh, okay.
Clue number three. This one's easy. Check around the TV.
Found it.
Wait.
Nope. I did not. Wow.
Good job. Clue number four. This is your last clue, so you can't stay put. Just look in the place where you put your foot. Think about what goes on your foot.
What goes on
there? That was a good idea, Maddie, that thought of it. What, think about our house and where does things with our feet happen?
Oh, the shoes are on that high heels.
Oh, you found it. So what did you find?
It's the Bible.
It's the Bible.
Yay.
So in today's lesson, we are learning about our last judge, Samuel. And he learns to listen to God's voice. And nowadays, we don't get to hear God's voice out loud usually, but we can hear God's voice when we read the Bible. So watch with us and let's celebrate. scripture memory verse. And it actually wasn't written by Samuel, the judge that we are talking about today. It was written by Jeremiah a long time after Samuel lived. We find it in Jeremiah 10:6. And it is reminding us of how great God is. And we actually just sang about it. And so the verse says, "Lord, there is no one like you. You are great. Your name is great in power." So we want to tell people about this God because he's wonderful. Is there anyone or anything greater than God? No. God is greater than everything and everyone. So we're going to learn about a new place in the world, and we're going to pray for that place. And Gabriel is going to introduce us to it.
Hi, my name is Gabriel. I am talking about Lebanon today. It's a country in the Middle East, bordering Syria and Israel. It's one of the smallest ones in the Middle East. The Lebanese flag has a cedar tree in the center. Has a cedar tree in the middle of it. It is impressive what they have. It used to be ruled by France, as was its neighbor Syria. When they were granted independence, it divided into multiple states. Lebanon and Syria eventually emerged. When Syrian troops took over Lebanon, people banded together to drive them out. So there has been a civil war since, its capital Beirut is now called the Paris of the South, of the Middle East. Bye.
Starting a new book of the Bible, 1 Samuel. And we are getting a great big picture view of what the whole Bible is about and the story of Jesus and his people. Our lesson today is about Samuel, who I told you was the last judge, and his mother, Hannah, couldn't have any babies. She wanted a baby so bad, and she talked to God and asked God to give her a baby. And she told God that if he gave her this gift, she would give it back to him. And so when Samuel was old enough, he went to live in the temple to do God's work. And we see from this that God loves to answer our prayers. He loves to give us what we want, but he doesn't want us to love the gifts more than himself, the giver. And so have you ever really wanted something badly and prayed to God and asked for it? God loves to answer our prayers. Let's see how God used Samuel, who Hannah asked for, and how God used him for his work.
In a country called Ephraim, a man named Elkanah lived with his wife, Hannah. Hannah was very sad because she did not have any children. Hannah wanted to have a family. Every year, Elkanah went to the tabernacle to make sacrifices to God and to worship him. Hannah went with him. Hannah prayed to God, "Lord, if you give me a son, I will dedicate him to you. he will serve you all of his life. A priest named Eli was sitting near the doorpost of the tabernacle. Eli watched Hannah pray. He couldn't hear her, but he saw her lips moving. Eli thought there was something wrong with Hannah. Hannah explained, "I've been pouring out my heart before the Lord." Eli replied, "Go in peace. May God answer your prayers." Hannah and Elkanah returned home, and God did answer her prayers. After some time, Hannah gave birth to a son. She named him Samuel. When Samuel was no longer a baby, Hannah took him to Eli at the tabernacle. "God answered my prayers," she said. Hannah pledged Samuel to serve God, and she worshiped God. Hannah returned home and left Samuel with Eli to serve God. Every year, Hannah returned with a new robe for Samuel, and God gave Hannah many more children. Eli was getting old, and his sons served as priests in the tabernacle. Eli heard that his sons were sinning against God. Eli asked his sons why they were sinning, but they did not listen to him. Samuel, on the other hand, grew older and found favor with God and with men. One night, Eli was in his bed and Samuel was lying in the tabernacle when Samuel heard someone call his name. He ran to Eli. "Here I am, you called me." But it wasn't Eli. He told Samuel to go back to bed. God called Samuel three times, and each time Samuel ran to Eli. "Here I am," he said. Eli finally understood that God was calling to Samuel. He told Samuel how to respond. Samuel went back to his place and God called, "Samuel, Samuel." "Speak, for your servant is listening," Samuel replied. God told Samuel that he was going to judge Eli's family for their sin. The next day, Samuel was afraid to tell Eli what God had said. Eli asked Samuel to tell him what God said, so Samuel did. As Samuel grew, God was with him. Everyone in Israel knew that Samuel was God's messenger. God used Samuel to share his plan with the nation of Israel. Samuel used God's words to tell the people what God is like. John chapter 1 verse 1 says, that Jesus is the Word. Jesus, the Son of God, told the world about God's plan and showed what God is like.
I love the way that God came looking for Samuel. Samuel learned to listen to God's voice and he did what he said. And God used him to give messages to the people, including Eli the priest. Eli's sons were supposed to be the next priests, but they didn't listen to God. Do you ever wish that you could hear God's voice the way that Samuel did? Samuel heard God, and we might never hear God's voice out loud, but we can know what God has to say by reading his Bible. The words in the Bible were written to us from God so that we could hear him. And God does not sit up in heaven and say, "You have to do more good works before I'll talk to you." No. God's already written down everything he wants us to know in the Bible, but we need to read it. So let's hear from our friend Miss Sarah an example of how she's heard from God by reading the Bible.
One of the ways God speaks to us is through his word. And by memorizing verses and reading the Bible daily, we can take the word of God with us throughout our lives every day. A few years ago, I had moved, I had started a new job, and I had a lot of big life changes going on. It was overwhelming and scary, and I felt alone. But God spoke to me through his word in Lamentations 3, verses 21 through 24. "But this I call to mind and therefore have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore I will hope in him." I was reminded that no matter how many changes I was facing in my life, that the Lord never changes. He will always love me and he will always be with me.
Thank you, Sarah, for sharing with us how God has spoken to you through the Bible. So you might be asking yourself, What if I don't understand what the Bible says? Well, if we don't understand, we can pray. When we read the Bible, we are also praying at the same time because praying is talking to God. So He's talking to us through the Bible and we're talking to Him through prayer. And He gave us the Spirit to help us. So we can pray and ask the Spirit to help us understand the words of the Bible. And if you don't understand, don't give up. Read it again. And you can ask someone for help. God didn't mean for us to learn about Him all by ourselves. We can read the Bible by ourselves and think about what God is telling us and pray to God. But then we can talk to other people. That is why I'm in a Bible study with others. And I ask them and they ask me and we help each other. You probably study the Bible with your family. That's also why we go to church, because the pastors have studied the Bible and they tell us what the Bible says and help us to understand. Because the Bible is a deep book, but it was written for God to talk to us, and He wants us to understand it. He's not trying to confuse us. So how do you read the Bible? Do you do it with your family? Do you have a book that helps you study the Bible with your family? Maybe you have a devotional. What do you do? Think about that, and I hope that you will spend more time studying the Bible with your family.